Hi guys, FrostFangs here, welcome back once again, of course, to another Paladins video. We're going to be playing some IO today. It's been a good couple months since I made an IO video. My loadouts have changed a little bit since then. I guess the meta playstyle for her has also kind of shifted a decent amount since that video I made a little while ago. I think it was in November, October, sometime around there. I'm trying my best to go through all the characters and find whichever ones it's been a long time since I've covered, and IO was on that list. I'm not sure who else is on there. I haven't actually got a list, so if you want to tell me in the comments who it's been forever since I've actually made a video on, to let me know, but IO is the focus of today's one. Got three different setups for her. These two are really, really similar, but this one is a little bit different, which I'd say is probably the meta choice I see for her the most often, which is using Swift Arrows, which I personally don't like all that much, but I can understand why people run it, and in a lot of situations it does work quite well. But personally, I still really like Protectors, which gives you Moonlight when you're near Luna, although depending on what talent you're going for on the playstyle, it doesn't necessarily make sense sometimes, and in that situation, I go for this one. They all have Sanctum of Faith in there, though. It regens Moonlight for every second you're not using it. Really, really nice card. Don't really understand why you wouldn't have this in a setup. And the bottom two have Protectors, which gives you Moonlight near Luna. They all, I think, have Restored Faith 3. Yeah, they do, which gives you 30 heal every time you heal an ally with a Moonlight. That might not seem like much, but then you realize that Moonlight heals every 0.15, and that's a pretty decent heal for 3 points into a card. Then we've got Moonwalk, which is kind of a new card for her, which increases your Moonlight capacity. I have it level 1 in this one, level 2 in the speed one, and level 3 in the variation of the one that I was just going through. It's the exact same as that one, except it has Protectors and Sanctum of Faith down a level each, and then Moonwalk is 3 instead of 1. Then they all also have Broken Deity, which increases Luna's deploy range by 20% for one level. Pretty decent. I did used to rock Celestial Body, and I feel like I kind of go back and forth between the extra health and the extra deploy range, but I feel like overall in most situations on most maps, that deploy range is a little bit more useful. I would say, honestly, IO has a pretty damn good selection of cards. She's got a couple stinkers in there, a few that aren't really all that useful that you don't see very often, but I'd say like 70 to 80% of her cards actually see used in-game. But yeah, this third setup is very, very similar to these other two. The only difference really is that Protectors is gone, and it's changed out for Swift Arrows so that you get a speed buff on your right click. I'm still kind of undecided on if I like this card or not. I don't think I've really played with it enough. Sometimes I feel like it's useful because, you know, you're giving somebody a movement speed buff, then they can also tell easier that they're being healed, and it does make a lot of plays go a lot smoother. But at the same time, in casual situations, it does also mess up a lot of plays, and you kind of ruin people's like kind of flow with what they're trying to do by giving them such a big movement speed buff. Really, it's just one of those cards that I think in some situations works great and in others not so much. We just went ahead and got a match. We got Onslaught or Siege. I queued for those two. We've got Siege Warder's Gate. Sure, that works pretty well for IO. We'll lock her in. We've also got an insta-locked Eevee and an Andro. We'll go ahead and stick with the pirate skin. I have got a new mount, the Sacred Wolf one. Is that what it's called? I'm not sure, but it was in a chest. I used 400 crystals on it because it was the only thing left in the chest, and I might as well just get that mount. Not sure how you were originally meant to get that mount. I'm not sure if it was in like a bundle or whatever, but I had 400 crystals and I rolled the chest, and obviously I got the last thing that was in it, and I haven't actually seen it yet in games. This will be my first impressions of a mount that's like a freaking half year old. Don't know why we have bothered to point it out, but we've got BK and Aram as the last two picks. Would say Rom combos quite well with IO. We've got a pretty decent team set up there. Did I already pop a booster? Yeah, I think I did. And it seems like we're basically up against the same thing with a Strix, an Andro, a Charlene, a Furia, and a Barak. Not really sure who I'd say has the team advantage here. I'd probably say it's even overall. The Andro looks kind of scary, level 162, but other than that, seems like pretty standard stuff. Honestly, I could go for Lifelink or Goddess's Blessing. I reckon both would probably work fine, but I think I'm going to go for Lifelink just so that I have two sources of heals. And considering I haven't actually shown off the speed loadout, I guess we can do it now. I'm not really sure that would be the right decision. I feel like I'm just going to go for a safe pick for this first match, and then maybe we'll go for the speed one if we do like an Onslaught or a TDM, because I feel like Siege might not be an ideal situation for it. We'll start out, I guess, with Haven, because they're basically all direct hit. Man, I'm not sure if I'm going to regret that decision. I feel like the speed could be useful. We've got Raw Subjects, Wormhole, Enforcer, Curse, Revolver, Nocturnal, Curse, Revolver, Forward to Fire, Recurve, and Cherish. We'll pop our Luna down, get some heals straight off the bat. I am already dead to the Strix because I was not paying enough attention. I did not realize he was all the way back there. That threw me off. Seems like two other people also died pretty early on in that round. Bit of a rough game so far. We are seemingly holding it, but they did a pretty damn good effort on that push. I feel like Strix specifically on their side is really kind of going through us. Andro is gone. There goes their Barak. Nice. Let's get a heal through to this Eevee. She's just blinking around like mad. I am trying to get heals to her here. Furia is the only person left on this side, and she is gone. There we go. Seems like most of the team is just choosing to push up. Ram is going to pop his F and run away. We can get some heals to him here. Honestly, not really having very much trouble against the rest of the team. It is pretty much just the Andro and the Strix who are getting rid of me. We are going to keep heals on this Rom as much as we can. Strix popped and all those heals on BK. He's dead to Andro. I'm not really sure what's going on. I'm going to F myself back a little bit here and try and stay alive. Charlene and Strix are just here. That Strix has got no health, but I have no idea where he's gone. Aram died, but we are somehow still holding this point. This is such a messy game, but there we go. Defense successful. Somebody on left who is over here. Oh, it's Furia. Okay, Andro just got rid of two of them. 1-1. We've got three ults up. This match is all over the place so far. Wouldn't say it's a bad match so far, but all three of my deaths are from pretty decent decent ranges from the Strix and the Andrew just hitting me from really far away. They've also got 4 quarterized 2s and a quarterized 1 on Fury already, straight off the bat. We've got 4 courts and also some Haven going. Throw our Luna down and play a little bit more aggressively, I guess, this time. Rom keeps running really far forward and it's kind of throwing me off. Rom is playing aggressively for a lot of this. Sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't. I'm trying to keep my Luna on the point to cap it. There's heals for Andrew. That took me a little while to realize what was going on there. We'll see if we can maybe get rid of Barak. Anyway, there we go. That's the 2-1. Nice. Didn't really do all that much. I kind of just sat on the point and healed people. Pretty much normally what you do on IO, so I can't really criticize myself too much. Just finished off Haven, which might not seem like the most sensible thing, but I am getting direct hit a lot. The amount of damage I've taken so far this game is way more than usual. Rom's saying, I've got 3 on me, you can't deal with a Barak. He has pushed up a little more than I think makes sense. Overall, they're on pretty damn high streaks, 11, 13, and 14. It's a pretty tough match. We've got court 3, court 3, court 3, court 2, court 1. We have 2 court 2s and 2 court 3s. Honestly, I feel like I'm doing fine so far, but people are pushing up a lot to the point where it's making me feel like maybe I'm playing way too defensively and I'm just not realizing. Anyway, it's going to round 3. This mount's kind of cool. I haven't mentioned it so far in this video. I haven't spent very much time on it, but it looks pretty. It's smoother than I thought it would be. I remember them being way more janky than this. But that's Andro going front all. We'll get heals onto the Ram for as much as I can. That's Charlene on me. Didn't even realize he was here. He went behind. Yeah, okay, that's why I didn't see him. Charlene went for a flank and then got rid of me before I even had time to react. It's such a weird match, honestly. I know I say that a lot, but this is quite a weird game. There's heals on EV. Charlene is here somewhere. We'll place our little Luna down. I'll go for an auto. Maybe see if we can get a couple people with that. That is 2. That didn't get me a kill, sadly. Andro didn't die. Maybe we can get a stun on the Charlene. Nope, I'm dead out of the Strix. Maybe I should get Illuminate. Maybe that would help. They're all on such goddamn big streaks. 19, 18, and 23. I don't feel like they're playing with like weird talents or weird loadouts or anything. They're just overall playing kind of strange. Everybody's playing a little bit differently than what you usually see in normal Paladins matches. It's making me kind of unsure if I'm just like experiencing everything as weird or if it's actually just strange. Strix is going for a push on left. I am now blind, but I am healing something. So I'm just going to keep holding right click. There is my F. Eevee is still alive. Rom, I think, popped his F and is now like deep into the enemy back line. I'm going to try and push up so I can get heals to people. There's 1, 2, Eevee. Actually, surprised she's still up. We'll get one on the Andro as well. There we go. He did get dinked right at that last second there by some small amount of damage. I think it must have been like an Andro shot or something. I don't know. Reposition our Luna so we can regen our Moonlight faster. There's a heal onto this BK who's nearly gone. Rom is out. See, I feel like people are pushing up, but maybe I'm just really far back. I don't know. BK just got rid of Barak. I'm going to F myself away, reposition our Luna, get more heals on him. Strix is there somewhere. I'm probably dead. Thank you for the body block, Barak. But now Charlene is here as well. I guess I'll die. I had Charlene on the right. I had Andro on the left and Strix up the middle. What the hell am I meant to do there? I'm just kind of playing around these little tree thingies here, whatever the hell they are, trying to keep this BK alive. I'm literally holding right click on him as hard as I can and he is gone. Hello, Andro. I'm dead. Well, it seems like it's going to be a 2-4. They've got it right at the goddamn edge there. Ram is popping his F. He's getting his damage reduction. They don't really have that much CC to pull him out of it, but there is the defeat. What a goddamn weird match. I don't know how well it's going to translate to the actual video, but that was such an odd, like, feeling game. People were playing really differently to how I usually see people playing Paladins matches, but whatever. BK is the man over top play. He gets a stun on Andro, gets rid of him. Sure, pretty straightforward stuff. Pops his F, gets rid of Charlene. Pretty smooth there. I'm not sure if that was mid-air inaccuracy helping or hurting him, but then finishes off with getting rid of Furia. Sure, pretty straightforward triple. All right, well, there we go. There are the stats for game one. Shoutouts to Sophie Ann, Frost, you shithole. This team made FrostFangs look decent. I'm not sure if that's a compliment or an insult or a backhanded compliment, but shoutouts to Savo. I don't know. Also, shoutouts to Darkmaster. That was one hell of a game. The stats page, I think, really does show that off. It felt weird as I was playing it, and as you can see from the stats, it really was quite a weird one. I guess we'll just go through them top to bottom. BK, I guess, did pretty decent. ADK damage isn't too bad. Eevee had a really, really weird stat there. 514, 40k. I guess I did pretty damn bad. You know, 099 is definitely not a good stat, but 32k damage, if you compare it to the rest of that match, really isn't too bad, considering I felt like I was doing basically nothing. And then we also had 86k heals. We actually had quite a comparable stat to the Furia, other than our KDA, obviously. Andro went 12, 20, 48k, which is also pretty rough. And Ram went 4, 12, 48k, which is also a pretty rough. I feel like overall, pretty much everybody on our side there has a rough stat. Don't even really feel like there's any point in me commenting over the stats page because they speak for themselves sometimes. But on their side, Andro did a great job. 23, 6, 81k. He didn't even really flank me all that much. I didn't feel like he was too big of an issue for me. Like, Strix was the biggest pain in the ass because he was just hitting me from a place where I couldn't really do anything about it. And as you can see from the stats, Eevee and Andro didn't do a particularly good job of getting rid of the Strix there, but Fury did pretty good, kind of similar stat to us, although that might be a bit of a stretch. Strix did a great job, 2,622k. That's a pretty damn mad stat. Barak also did pretty good, 10, 5, 70k. And then Charlene also did pretty decent, 11, 8, 83k. That was a really weird match. Don't know if there's anything else I missed in the chat, but I don't think there is, so let's just jump into another game. I guess we'll just queue for another Onslaught or a Siege. I feel like that really didn't do a great job of showing off IO, not even because I was playing badly, but because I was really, really far behind the team for a lot of that match, or really separated from the team would be a better way to word it. There weren't even enemies in between me and the rest of my teammates. I'm not sure if it was me playing really, really safe and defensively, or like the rest of my team playing super aggressive, but there were just so many plays there where I was trying to do one thing and the team was trying to do another, and I just feel like there was a decent amount of mismatch there. Not that either of us were necessarily wrong, I don't know, I just feel like there were a decent amount of plays there where we were pushing up when we really didn't need to push up, and we probably could have played a little bit safer with the flanks going around and trying to deal with like the Strix and the Fury and stuff. But anyway, whatever, it's just a Paladins match, let's jump into a game two. It really isn't all that deep. Right, well, for game two, we've got King of the Hill Magistrates Archives. We're going ahead and locked in our IO. We've got a Vivian, a Dredge, a Maeve, and an Inara. Inara combos quite well. We're up against a Strix, a Koga, a Damba, another Inara, and a Ying. Not sure if there's anybody who was in the last match, but there's a couple names I think I've played with before on their side. Maybe the Koga and the Damba. Not sure. We'll go ahead and grab our lifelink, and I guess we can go for the speed setup here. There's Inaras on both sides, so maybe going for a speed buff will help her out. I don't know. We've got Booby Trap, Rogue's Gambit, Mother's Grace, Hurl, Mother's Grace, Ripen to Gourd, Focusing Lens, Adrenaline Junkie, and Unauthorized Use. All super standard stuff. I guess I can throw my Luna straight on the point to hold down Inara. We'll get some heals through to the Maeve. Did actually manage to just clip her there, although I'm pretty sure she's still a goner. Managed to get her with another little bit of a heal onto these guys. Speed buff them a little bit so they can push up. There we go. Definitely feels like I'm regening Moonlight slower, but hey, whatever. We'll get a couple hits onto her. Luna, go and do a dash or just hit her a little bit. I don't know. I'm throwing in a couple little shots. We'll F ourselves over here and get a heal through to the Dredge. That was kind of smooth. Having to run up to the Dredge again to try and get heals to him, but he's dead to Koga. I guess we can maybe avenge him. There we go. That works too. We'll get some heals down to the Inara. I'm kind of just leaving Luna to do all the work, which is actually working so far. We can get a couple hits, maybe get a stun. There we go. That's kind of nice. Strix is over there trying to earn some shots. Luckily, he's not as good as the Strix who was in the last match. Kind of dominated this point so far. Vivian, if you just pop a little bit out to the left, I can heal you. There we go. If I can just keep vision, she should be fine. Nice. We'll get a stun up to the Inara. For some reason, Luna just cancelled her decision midway through the animation. That was janky. Just threw Luna straight on the point. I guess that works. We'll get a couple heals through. Strix is getting rid of me here. I'm not really sure what my plan is. I guess I can just run. That's him going for an ult, so I guess I'll just die. Literally just ran away from a Strix into a goddamn Koga ult. We'll finish off our Nimble. We'll get a little bit of Haven. Sure, why not? Dredge fighting point blank with a Koga. He lost because Ying was ulting. I think that is our Inara going for an ult. There we go. Sound effect was kind of quiet. Team isn't pushing up for some reason, but it's whatever. There goes Inara. We'll get some more heals on out of the Maeve, even though she doesn't need it. Gives it a speed buff, which is kind of nice. Heals on to Vivian. Strix is kind of going for a flank here. There we go. He's out. Heals on to her. I did just let Dredge die, which is a bit of a shame. Throw more heals onto Vivian. There we go. Is she going to push up? I feel like I should stay here just to make sure she doesn't die as easily. But they managed to recover most of their score. I'm going to go for like a bit of a cheeky ult, see if we can pull this off. That didn't get anybody. Was really hoping that would at least get the goddamn Ying, but hey, I guess we still killed it. Just took a little minute. Let's get rid of Damba. Never mind, I'm dead at a Strix. That's happened so many times in this goddamn video, is I'm just doing my own thing and a Strix who is really far away kills me. This match has definitely been a lot of back and forth so far, but there's heals onto you. We'll throw our Luna down just to get area heals. We'll get some more onto him. I think Inara's going for an ult. Either that or she's just standing still and firing. I can't tell because she's CC immune, so it just looks like she's not doing a freaking animation. You know, Paladins might be a little bit scuffed when you can't actually tell if somebody's ulting or not because half the time they don't play animations. I think Koga's over here. Oh, he is. There's a little dink on him. Cool. We'll just wiggle back towards the point. I feel really fast now that we've got Max Nimble. Honestly, I feel like if I was playing a goddamn damage character in either of the matches today, I'd have such a ridiculous stat. Let's go in on this Strix. We should be able to get rid of him, right? Oh, smooth moves. There we go. He absolutely bodied. That actually worked. I mean, we did get him with a bit of a cheeky stun, I think, but he did try and invis and get out of it. Let's get rid of the Damba. There we go. We'll throw out some more shots. I feel like I need to shift my goddamn playstyle because the team isn't focusing on damage enough. I feel like I need to maybe do a little bit more. He's going for an ult again. I'm trying to get some heals. I'm not really sure who I should be focusing. We should be able to get rid of him here though, right? Yeah, okay, there we go. Not sure if that's actually Adrix or not. I don't know what his actual Paladin's account is, but I think it might be him. Either way, he's doing a pretty good job. We'll throw Luna on the point, get some heals to this Maeve, get a couple heals up there to the Inara. Get a couple shots on this Ying, I guess. Luna, you want to go in for a stun? No? Okay, cool. She's dead anyway. We'll pop our F. Never mind. I'm feared. I can still pop it in this direction. Never mind. I'm stunned. Finally. Jesus Christ. How many times do I have to hit a button before I can actually do it? I am blinded, so I guess I'll just die. I feel like overall we're only going to win this because we've been playing the point more than them, and it's really important on King of the Hill. Otherwise, we'd be completely screwed here. More heals onto Dredge. Get some heals onto Vivian. Sure. Well, another messy play, but it seems like we're winning this one. We'll get a couple hits onto the Inara. I would have so much goddamn damage if I was playing this match as any character other than IO. How did you just deploy a wall while looking in a different direction? I have no idea. This is honestly such a scuffed game. Koga's going for an ult. Get some heals onto her. Okay, I'm stunned. Get some heals onto the Vivian at the back. Either way, there we go. There is the victory. Not sure who's going to have top play. My guess is Koga because he was definitely playing the best on their side. Yep, there we go. Definitely seems like matchmaking was expecting him to carry his side and me to carry my side. I think that happens all the time, but he popped his ult. He got rid of me. He got rid of Vivian. He goes ahead and pops a dash. He finishes off the Inara, and I'm guessing he also gets rid of dredge. Anyway, there we go. There are the stats for game two. We'll go top to bottom. Maeve, 8-15, 50k. Definitely not a great stat. We went 6-8, 60k, 82k. I'm more than happy with that considering the situation there. I feel like that's fine. Dredge did pretty decent. 18-12, 67k. Vivian did fine as well. 6-10, 68k. And Nara did all right. She played the objective 4-5, 40k. Ben the human just asked where you're recording. Shoutouts to him. FrostFangs, that's a first. Shoutouts also to Migvas99. Not really sure how to pronounce names, but on their side, Ying did okay. She definitely could have done better, but she didn't do terribly. Koga definitely did a good job there. 26.99k. Maldamba did fine. The Inara was definitely worse than our Inara. Probably the worst person in that match there, judging from the stats and how she was playing in game. But you know, she did play the point, I guess. And then Strix also did pretty decent. 20-7, 95k. About the same as the Koga. Kind of surprised we won that. We'd honestly put it down to objective time, but yeah, a bit of a weird game. I'm gonna be honest with you. I have no idea what today's video was. We just played two really, really strange games. I don't know how well it will come across in video form, but playing them was really strange. I feel like I was trying to do my best. I was throwing up my heels. I was doing my cue, but I just felt super desynced from what the team was doing. It was a bit better in the second one because I could just throw my loot on the point. Most of the team were playing around the objective. Basically, I felt like if I was ever in a one-on-one fight, I was kind of screwed if I didn't have a team member with me. Kind of weird. I don't know if that says a lot about IO or if that says a lot about how I play IO or about the matches we just had, but there we go. I'm just telling you how I feel. So yeah, I guess we'll just end the video here. I honestly don't really know what else to say. The loadouts worked fine. I don't feel like I did a particularly bad job of playing IO, but I feel like she's just really, really average in comparison to the other healers for casual games. I'm not talking about how she is for like pro tier stuff or like ranked or whatever. I'm just talking about straight casual matches. She feels really underwhelming and like not really that satisfying to play because a lot of those fights were just me kind of right-clicking somebody, hoping they survive until they eventually don't. And that kind of kept happening over and over again. You know, I could fire, I could get a stun, I could throw my Luna or whatever, but I just felt like I really didn't make that big of a difference during my matches. And I think that is something that I feel usually when I play IO. You know, if I have a really, really good match that ends up going like 3-3 and it's super tense and both of the teams are super even, she's really rewarding to play and tons of fun because you feel like you're making such a big difference. But I think in most casual matches, you don't get that and she just feels kind of limp. That's what I'm going for. I'm going for the word limp. Yeah, screw it. So yeah, I'm just going to end the video here. Thank you so much for watching. Leave a like if you enjoyed. Of course, I'll see you guys all very, very soon. And as always, stay frosty.